Welcome to our workshop on recently published organ music. The music that we're using today are part of music that I have received from publishers actually over the last 20 years or so. For about 20 years, I've been reviewing organ music for a United Methodist publication called Worship and Arts, which comes out quarterly. And publishers send me music with the hopes that I'll write something favorable and encourage people to purchase their music. And so today we're going to be going through music in an alphabetical order by composer. Many of you already have received the list of publications that I've received. Most of the publications on the list are from the last 4 or 5 years. I have included a few things that are like 10 years old, 15 years old, simply because I think that they are of significance and you might want to consider purchasing those. For example, I'm going to start with an Ashland Confession, Franklin Ashland, Ashdown, Joyful We Adore Thee, and I'm going to play this all the way through. Many of the pieces that I'm going to play, I'm only going to play sections. If you have tuned into this workshop thinking that you were going to have an organ concert or an organ recital, you're going to be very disappointed, because I'm just going to be playing sections of these pieces to give you an idea of the music in them. The reason I'm playing this first piece in its entirety is to give you an indication that much of this music, although the title doesn't say partita, it actually is composed in a partita form in the sense that you could choose some sections of it and not play other sections. For example, you will see and you will hear in this first one, there are sections that could be played for a short prelude, a short offertory, a short postlude, or even an introduction to the hymn with the tune Dix. Some of these are for manual only, some are all three parts. None of these for this particular one have melody in the pedal, although some of the ones later on you will hear do have that. So, without talking any more, we're going to start now, and I'm going to play Franklin Ashdown's arrangement of Dix. Thank you. I'm going to play from Callahan's melodic suite, and I'm going to play, there are four movements in this, and I'm going to play little selections from each of the four movements, just to indicate for you the different sorts of styles that there are in these four movements. Callahan, of course, has written many, many, I think he has over 300 published works. I'm not going to do any of the repeats that are in here. I'm just going to play some parts of each of the movements.
Thank you.
This next piece is also in a partita form, although it's not labeled as partita. It's on All Things Now Living, so I will simply skip through. I will not play a whole section through in a part, but to give you an idea of the different parts to this little piece. Section. Next piece by Michael Costello is actually an arrangement on Ein Feste Berg, which we heard from Michael Bedford, our national AGO president, earlier. This again is the same tune. This comes in six sections. Actually, Michael Costello and his wife are both ordained clergy, and he has written a number of creative arrangements on hymn tunes. And each of these sections is standalone. Some are for manuals only. You'll catch on as you listen.
Thank you.
Eludemer, and it doesn't really sound like I'm Eludemer. You'll notice that this is actually published several years ago. The reason I included that is for those of you that play in churches with our blended music, this is has some good contemporary folk music written by, composed by Eludemer. You'll hear Josh will be playing some Eludemer, which is more in the style of Eludemer. I'm going to play a piece now by Dennis Janzer based on a black spiritual. It is published by Wayne Leopold. I'll be talking a little bit more about some Wayne Leopold music a little later. You ought to consider his publications because he has a number of really exciting compositions by contemporary composers.
Thank you.
Some of you that have been organists for a long time in Central New York will remember that Wayne Leopold actually got a degree from Syracuse University with Arthur Poister, and was an organist here and choir director in a number of churches. He has a number of publications. The Greensboro Collection has a number of very well-known contemporary composers, for example, John Brock, Robin Dinda, Alfred Friedeck, Rachel Lauren, Kenneth Logan. I'm going to play a selection for manuals only, organ sonata by a Rogil Berko. It has a number of movements, and again, I'm going to play just a little section of each of the movements for you. Companion. This is published every 2 months. It always has some Baroque music, it has some Romantic music, and it has music by contemporary composers. It always has about half of the music that is for either manuals only or for just a one or two pedal notes. So it is for organists that need to get something rather quickly ready to play. If this was not a virtual concert, actually Wayne Leopold sent me copies of this, and sometime when we can all be together, those of you can get free copies of this publication. This is actually from the March 2019, because the conference was, this workshop was originally scheduled for March of 2020. And at that point, because he was sending these the end of February, the one for this year had not yet been published. So he sent me from the March of the previous year. I'm going to play just one selection, Because You Live, by George Lackenauer, that's there. Again, just to give you an indication of something that is for manuals only, but very listenable music and very easy to prepare. Thank you. I'm playing from the Robert Powell collection of 4,000 tongues, the Awake the Vocanove, which is a very short, different kind of arrangement than the Bach that many of us play from the Schubert arrangement. This is a good short offertory or short prelude if you're using the Vocanove at another point in the worship. He is born. I'm going to play four sections of four contemplations on the hymn tune Picardy. Mark Radice actually has a number of connections here with Central New York. He has his doctorate from the Eastman School of Music, and he is currently on the organ faculty at Ithaca College.
Thank you.
playing from Roberta Rowland Rabel's collection of Summer Solstice. She has a number of connections with New York State too. She was the youngest member of the Westchester County chapter of the AGO. She later became the dean of that chapter. She was New York State convener. And she also taught for the Summer Institute for several years at Hartwick College. The next collection that I'm going to play from is also one of the older ones on the list. The reason I'm doing this, those of you who play in a United Methodist church or an Episcopalian church or in a Lutheran church where you are expected to play while people come forward for communion, you know that you're never quite sure ahead of time how many people are going to be there and how long you're going to have to play. And this has a sequence on communion hymns. I'm just going to play, starting at the beginning, a little bit of it to show how one goes right into the next one. And you can start at the beginning and play for as long as you need to play. Goes on for 25 more pages. The last two things I will be playing are from Weber. There's from the Lent Mosaics. An arrangement of Our Dearest Jesus.
Thank you.
And finally, the partita on Yigdal in some hymnals, that's also known as the tune Leone. There are five different movements to this. I'm just going to play actually the first, all the way through the first movement, the first part of the partita.